Here, too, the mission is being flown. Nonetheless real for being in the minds and hearts of these men behind. Ask anybody who's been to a field in England or anywhere else our bombers are based, and he'll tell you that there's drama here, too. Waiting to see who's coming back. To watch them, you might not realize how tense these ground crews are. But they are tense and plenty worried. In Air Force talk, this waiting is known as sweating out the mission. These men know the flight plan. Their watches told them when the bombers were running into enemy flak, when they were over the target, when they left the enemy coast. And now their watches tell them the bombers should be nearing the field. Every ear strains for the first sound of the engines. And then somebody hears them. And somebody sees the first faint specks in the distant sky. Every face turns to see and count. The watchers try to read the numbers on the ships. These planes have priority to land first. The colored flares mean wounded aboard. In the hospital window, these watching men know what that means. They know what it feels like to lie on a bouncing fortress floor for hundreds of miles through the frozen stratosphere in great pain, with the other men in your crew fighting to keep you alive until they hit the field. The field. Home. It'll be okay then. Because there'll be medical care. The best. As soon as the wheels of your plane stop rolling. Head wound. Concussion. 20-millimeter cannon shell exploded in his radio compartment. Shock. Internal injuries. He'll be all right, though. Flak burst scattered flying shrapnel. He's full of steel splinters. This pilot's leg is not a pretty sight. Neither are the docks at Wilhelmshaven. These men will all get the Purple Heart. And this man, too. Posthumously. A transfusion right in the plane. This gunner is too weak to be moved. The new life-giving blood flowing into his veins might be the blood of a high school girl in Des Moines, a minor in Alabama, a movie star in Hollywood, or it might be your blood, whosever it is. Thanks. Thirty-six planes left this field this morning. Now six more arrive. That makes 20 home. And this one's 21. More wounded aboard. Twenty-two. Coming in with his left inboard engine dead. 23. With a feathered prop on his left outboard engine. 24, Southern Comfort, with a chunk of tail gone. 25, they flew home on their luck. 26, not a scratch. The control tower learns that two more landed at a British field to the south. One a crash landing, crew safe. That makes 28. 29. A rough landing, but her pilot's badly hurt. It's a wonder he brought her back at all. 29 planes back. So far. 29 out of 36. Our losses were heavy. But the enemies were far heavier. We destroyed a German aircraft factory, a rail junction, submarine pens, docks, and harbor installations. That's specific, known damage. But who can tell the number of German torpedoes that will not be fired? The number of our convoys that will get through now? The soldiers' and seamen's lives that will be saved? Or the battles that will be won instead of lost because of what these bombers and airmen did today? Pilot and tail gunner. They can laugh now. Fire on the inboard engine did this. Flames streaked back and burned the stabilizer, too. Another crew luck brought back. Here's old Bill. A pretty good airplane when it took off. Lost its nose. Lost its navigator. Bombardier wounded. Top turret gunner and pilot hit. Hydraulic system shot out. No brakes. No flaps. But old Bill came back. Now, among the returned crew members, talk flows like a river, talking out every detail of the mission. These are the faces of combat, faces of Americans who have watched their comrades die, faces that can never forget the enemy. And they're in no mood to have their picture taken. In the control tower, Colonel Ray, the group CO, is still watching and waiting. And then he spots the last flight. Three more planes. And one of them is the ship everyone has been pulling for. The Memphis Belle. The last few miles of this trip have been a joyride. The strain is over. They can leave their guns now. Now they know they're going to go home. To Spokane, Green Bay, Asheville, Detroit, Chicago, Fort Worth, and Yonkers. The Belle comes in for a landing. But first Morgan buzzes the field, cuts the grass with the giant fortress. It's against the rules, but this is a special occasion.